Ladies and gentlemen, sorry for the interruption due to the technical error. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I am Rudy, your host for today's webinar. It gives me immense pleasure welcoming you all to the live webinar on the theme of Accelerating Design Concepts. The webinar is hosted by Cyber Media Research in association with HP Inc. For the duration of presentation, all participants' line will be in listen-only mode. After the presentation, we will have a question and answer session. Your feedback is very important for us. Please submit your feedback at the end of the webinar. Now, I would like to hand over the floor to Mr. Thomas George, President, Cyber Media Research, who will share his insights on Be Unstoppable. Mr. Thomas, welcome to the program. You are now ready to begin.
Thank you, Rudy. Thanks a lot. A very good afternoon to every one of you. I hope I'm audible, and before I really get into the session, I would like to just give a quick introduction of this initiative called Be Unstoppable. You all must be wondering that today's topic is about accelerating design concepts and what is Be Unstoppable all about. Be Unstoppable is a program, knowledge enablement program for small, medium businesses across the country. And this we have brought in a partnership with Hewlett-Packard Inc. to help the SMBs to grow and to be really unstoppable in their sphere of businesses. Now, before really starting today's webinar, I would like to just present few market overviews to you, few data points which says that how SMBs are a great place of opportunity, rather growth opportunity altogether. So if you look at in Indian IT spending today, it's growing at a 6.7%, and this is likely to be upward of $90 billion this year. This I'm talking about IT spending, domestic IT spending overall. And we could see that a lot of metros within the country is today among the 10 fastest growing city by the GDP altogether. And specifically talking about small, medium enterprises and SMBs in the Indian context, they are around close to 75 million odd SMBs, and 53 of them are digitally led or digitally connected. And this combinedly drives a kind of a business of around $30 billion altogether as of now. And this SMB is going to contribute around close to 77% of India's incremental GDP growth altogether. But at the same time, when this provides a wonderful opportunity for SMBs to really grow in various verticals and sub-vertical, it's also led in with a lot of challenges because it is pretty fragmented and scattered all across the country. Now, even McKinsey talks about around close to 49 industry clusters, which are growing at a much faster rate than the Indian GDP growth rate altogether. That means they are the hotbed for the growth. And all the SMBs, especially the participants today in this webinar, you might be also witnessing in your own businesses, there is a good growth opportunity all around. And to talk about the challenges which is pertaining to SMBs, there are few challenges, lack of right understanding, especially the functional abilities at times, the mentorship, the resources, the infrastructure which a larger organization can afford sometimes may not be at disposable for SMBs. So we felt that there is a need for a platform, a knowledge platform which can not only bring the right knowledge, skills, mentorship, rewards and recognition for small and medium businesses in the country. And that's where the Be Unstoppable program took birth. And it's nothing but we have brought some like-minded friends and partners together with us, a software partner like Tally, Freshworks, and Kotak, who is our banking partner, addressing to the needs of business owners of the SMBs, the functional heads, whether they are HR heads or IT heads or finance heads, and the IT managers, the practitioners. For all these three type of or persona of SMB CXOs, we are providing business and strategy understanding, skill and knowledge imparting, and mentorship, and help in helping them to understand what are the ways they can either raise capital or they can arrange finances. Now, these can be delivered through various medium, be through today's webinar, for example. Today, my co-presenter, Senthil Raj from HP, is going to talk about how to accelerate the design concepts. So this is one example how we enhance the skills of our SMB partners and community members altogether. Mentorship, which is available, you can go onto our website, Be Unstoppable, and you can register. You will get newsletters which will enable you with a lot more knowledge around mentoring, finance, skills, and various other aspects of developing the business and getting into a next growth orbit altogether. We have we are showcasing the partner products and solutions as well. And with this program, if you are if you have attended these in the past, you would have noticed that we have touched upon IT webinars like aspects of security, outsourcing of IT infra, everything as a service, customer experience, also on general topics like GST, on right workstations, how to really choose a right workstation. And we also go around the country, city by city. As we are talking right now, there is a conference going on in Nagpur where IT managers as well as the business owners are attending, and one full day of networking sessions where they have master classes. They have mentors talking to them, mentors like Padmasri Bhaktavachalam and various other well-known speakers who come to this forum and impart their knowledge and advices to our partners. Needless to say, as it says in the slide itself, a variety of assets are available, infographics, case studies, videos, white papers, polls, and tutorials for everybody across the function. And I would like to conclude this session with two slides, which says that digital adoption is soaring very high, but at the same time, the cost is tumbling. A few data points are here, like the amount of smartphones we have per 100 people in the country today, it's around close to 30. And if you look at total number of internet users, we are around 570-odd million internet users are there. So needless to say that we are completely digital enabled, and we are at the cusp of the hockey stick growth, where we can really see how SMBs can push Indian economy, because it contributes on three major pillars of our country's economy in terms of GDP, in terms of employment, and in terms of exports. It forms around close to 40% of the exports right now, which will increase to the contribution will increase around close to 75% by 2024. And the employment, it will contribute around close to 45% of the Indian employment, and SMBs GDP contribution will be in terms of around close to 50% by 2024. So, and there will be lot many new sectors, lot many new sub-verticals who will gain dominance or high growth orbit altogether, and they will come from job and skills, financial services, agri-tech, education, logistics, and retail. There are a few numbers mentioned over here. These are the ranges in which this opportunity will be available for the Indian SMBs. So I think great opportunity for us, great opportunity for us to be around in the form of Be Unstoppable and cater to this community and be a part of this growth engine altogether. Thank you so much for having us and being a part of our community. Visit our websites which is mentioned over here. Register for the newsletters, and I'm sure you will be updated with all the details, all the proceedings at our end. Thank you, Rudy. I'll be happy to take the questions as and when Rudy allows me to.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for the participation. Now, I would like to request if you wish to ask any questions, please press 0 and 1 on your telephone keypad for the participants who have joined through the audio. Participants who have joined through the WebEx, if you wish to ask any questions, you can put your queries on the chat appearing on your right side of the window. Repeating and requesting again, ladies and gentlemen, if you wish to ask any questions, participants joining on the audio, please press 0 and 1 on your telephone keypad. Simultaneously, participants joining on the WebEx, please post your queries on the chat appearing on the right side of the window. No indications and no further question and answer. Would like now to introduce the next speaker for the call, Mr. Senthil Raj, Technical Consultant, Workstation HP Inc. He will share his insights on the accelerating design concepts. Mr. Raj, welcome to the program. You are now ready to begin.
Thank you so much, Rudy. And Thomas, it's a great insight you've given the completely how India is growing on the small, medium business segment. And it was a great insight. Thank you so much once again. And myself, Senthil Raj Balakrishnan, I'm the technology consultant for HP Z Workstation. I support entire country for the supporting the workstation product, how to choose the right product based on your application, based on your data set. So how HP giving the right solution on that. Okay, so before I start with our session, you know, this is my second webinar over the last year, last financial year for Be Unstoppable. I have given the presentation on the how to choose your workstation based on your application. So today we are going to speak about, you know, how the technology working, how do you choose your workstation, and how you can increase your performance choosing the right hardware and the right application, how to manage your data set and the current situation. So that I'm going to speak about that. So starting getting into the exact presentation, so small information about HP. HP is a Fortune 100 company. We are exit with a $53 billion company, and globally we have 250,000 channel partners. So we are working with them. And HP holds 18,000 patents, and we have operations in the across the globe, 170 countries. We have operation, 50,000 employees plus. So this is our HP's strength where we work for that. Coming about HP workstation, Z workstation. So we are in the business almost 35 years. So advantage of choosing Z workstation. So if you talk about our competitor space, whoever to build a workstation. So either the workstation will be part of the enterprise, that is part of the server class hardware, or part of the edge device, it's the part of desktop or laptop division. Whereas HP is the only company, workstation is a separate portfolio, separate business unit. So we more focused about that, you know, the people who develop a product or who work on the engineering and construction, or who work on the media and entertainment, or who work on the automotive space, or who work on the financial segment, or who work on the education. So these are the segments where workstation is largely deployed and it used. So what is workstation? So maybe some people, I'm sure the last time when we had a session, people have a different opinion. So workstation is a hardware. It is an edge device. Edge device means it's used in your desktop. So this device is equipped with the very, very high availability hardware in terms of CPU, in terms of memory, in terms of graphic, or in terms of storage. So how you get the power from the server, same power you get it from your desktop. So you don't need to power on this device in the data center environment. So the same device can be used in the your desk side and any weather condition, HP Z workstation works. So if you talk about, we have a customer in the Siachen lab, or we have a customer in the Jaisalmer. So two extreme weather conditions, HP workstation can be used on that. So that, you know, our main conversation, you know. So when I was talking to the couple of customers in the small medium segment, most of the time customer will ask mainly, how do I choose my right hardware? What is my biggest challenge? So these are all the points most of the time whenever we get into the conversation with that, you know, the partner or the, you know, small medium business customers. So they get that because of the enterprise customers or the large global customers. They have a team, they work with the consultant or the specific OEM. So they recommend the right solution for that. But when it comes to the small medium customers, based on their experience or the channel partner who guide them to choose the hardware, it may mislead and their investment is not right. So that may be a lead to their production or that, you know, the business development. This will be on the stake. So keeping in that, so I will be recommending the right solution or how HP is enabling, what are the tools available to choose your product and maximize your performance using the right application and maximize your performance. So when I say that, you know, I given the various segments, product development or architect, media and entertainment customer, are the people who work on the financial, people who work on the virtual reality, are people who work on the data science. So these are the area where that technology is going and we need to choose the right solution. Otherwise, our investment is not protected. So when you say design guys, so people, the workstation users, typically they use for a CAD application or a simulation application or for the design application or they may use for rendering. So these are all the situations where the workstation will be used for that. So what are the challenges they face there? So largely, if you talk about visualization, okay, or the people who work on the content development, so the data are now day by day, it is growing, and the models are growing, and the applications are more complex, and the data size are very, very extreme. So if you talk about the CAD file, it used to be in the MBs, now it is in the TVs. So that much complex data. Earlier, we used to work on the application for every application individual. Now we work on the every application suite. So you need to have a more resource hardware for that. Coming to that, you know, when you have a more complex data, unless otherwise, if you have an optimized configuration, you can't meet your project timeline. And unless otherwise, if you have a technology where you can collaborate and work with the people, so you have a biggest challenge. So these are the things, actually, if you talk about the current situation, biggest pain on that. So let's talk about one by one how HP is giving a solution. Very, very simple format. When you go and buy a 1 lakh rupees worth of hardware, so maybe you can look into that, you know, processor, RAM, hard drive, or graphic card, where it is certified, tested. So you will not know anything. So where workstation is the only hardware in the across the globe, it is certified by the various software vendor. That is called ISV certification. So if you talk about people who work on the product development, they may use applications like AutoCAD or PTC Creo or Dassault Systems CATIA or Siemens UG. So you talk about any of the applications. So they recommend one configuration, they certify a configuration. When they're recommending a configuration, you can use your laptop or you can use your desktop, can be used. But when it comes to the product development, so you need to have a certified configuration. So workstation is the only hardware certified by the various ISVs. So that is a very, very important thing. So when you're choosing application, make sure you are certified hardware you are investing. Coming to the, when you choose that, you know, complex data, so what are the bottlenecks? Every application demands a different set of hardware. If you talk about CAD applications or the design applications, people who work on the media and entertainment or the architect, Revit, people who work on the BIM application and that, you know, the construction field. So every set of applications need specific hardware with a specific hardware specification. So how do I choose that? So which I said, any of the CAD application, any of the simulation application, any of the BIM application, if you need, go and choose that, make sure you are buying a desktop hardware also with the highest clock frequency processor. That gives the maximum performance. So most of the time people will say, okay, I have a budget of 10 lakh rupees. So this which I got to investment from my finance guy, so let's go and spend money. So not like that. So when you're choosing application, you need to, depends on the application, you need to choose the right hardware. So the complex data, that data is growing, and then when you're using the application with like a suite, CAD and simulation application, or design and rendering application, both combined, you're going to use in the same machine. So you need to choose the right hardware, like, you know, the processor which I said, which you have a highest clock frequency, plus you should have a good graphic card. The graphic card should be certified by the, again, various software vendors. So that helps you to improve your performance. So most of the time, what will happen, people will like think about a graphic card for the design application. So in the market, there will be two types of graphic cards available. One is a consumer graphic card, one is a commercial graphic card. Consumer graphic cards largely to play your games. So most of the games industry, which is actually there in that market now, so it is a more AI-based game. So which need to perform, you need to have a high compute power machine secured. So technically, NVIDIA or AMD, they build a biggest graphic card, but that is made for gaming purpose. But when it comes to the professionals, people who work on the segment, different application, various professional applications, so you need to choose the professional graphic card. So with right hardware, that maximize your performance. So that is the important element when it's choosing the, another hardware. Third thing, collaboration. Today's situation, people are sitting in various parts of the world and they'll be connecting. If you talk about today's situation, so across the country, the webinar is heard by various people, 100 plus audience they're hearing, and we are interacting each other, right? So virtually we are connecting. So when it comes to the collaboration in the professional environment or the design environment, so project lines are, timelines are, very, very tight, and we work on different time zones. India is like, segment where we support globally almost all the regions. Like, our day never ends. So from, we talk about call center guys, they start from morning 6 to next day morning 6. So 24/7, 365 days, various time zone people will be supporting. But that is for the, there is a technology available. When it comes to the people who work on the design, people who work on the product development, so the applications, the time zones, how do I collaborate? I can't transfer my data. It is in the TBs. So I can't upload it in the cloud or something where I have that, the data security. These are all the things coming into the picture. So we need to think from that, how we can collaborate on the real time. Okay. So these are all the technology which we help you to maximize your performance. And these are all the bottleneck if you talk about in the professional scenario. So HP, keeping all this pain area, talk about large amount of data or the technology, like new technology like VR, or you want to work on the AI tools, or if you want to do the rendering or simulation in the same hardware. So these are all the pain areas, like when it comes to the visual artists, are the people who work on the designs guys. So these are all the pain area. How HP as a Z workstation family giving a solution for that? So maybe I will talk about every product and every segment it is made for HP workstation is giving a solution for all your pain areas. So when we build a machine, HP workstation, we keep three pillars. That is our main DNA. So performance and innovation and reliability. We talk about performance, HP Z workstations, we started almost 10 years now. This earlier XW series, so people we migrated from XW to Z series the year of 2008. So when we migrated, we come out with a lot of innovation things we bring inside that. If you talk about liquid cooling technology, if you talk about that small form factor workstation, or if you talk about convertible, portable workstation, or if you talk about the modular chassis, so these are all the innovation things we build in our workstation. When it comes to the performance, HP, we always keep performance is the most highest priority. right? Because of the, when it comes to the workstation, so person need a most powerful machine. So 2008, when we build a machine, we build with the highest memory. In this RAM, we used to offer 512 GB memory. Then after 4 years, we started with that. No, we used to offer 1 TB memory in the workstation. Then with third generation machine, we started with the 2 TB memory. The current generation machine, we are certifying up to 6 TB memory. I'm talking about the RAM. So that much memory where we can give it in the workstation side. Similarly, when it comes to the storage, we go and give up to 48 TB storage we offer in the workstation. So this is like, you know, performance, never ever we compromise on that quality and the performance side. So reliability, so which I said at the beginning of that, you know, the workstation is the hardware, can be used at any environment. So when you give a more performance, so you need to have a reliable hardware. So HP workstations are, you know, pioneer in this technology. We build our machines with that, you know, more reliable solutions. We always come out with that, you know, new innovative things in the workstation to get a more reliable hardware. So we have a machine in the Siachen lab. We have a machine in the Jaisalmer lab. So extreme weather condition are minus or the highest temperature. So our workstations are more reliable and it works on that. So when it comes to the flexibility side, so we build a machine like, you know, this unstoppable program last year, Thomas was mentioning, you know, across the country, we hosted that, you know, various day program. So one of the, I never forget the word used by the one of the artists came from the media segment customer. So he was using an X2 product, which you are seeing in that screen. So he felt, so this is mobile studio. He used the word, underlined the no slogan kind of thing. X2 kind of hardware is a mobile studio because of his artist. He sit in the forest, he make a live shooting, and he want to do editing, so he can't carry a biggest hardware in that, you know, middle of the night or 24/7, 365 days he travel, but he can't carry a biggest hardware. So he gives that, you know, he use a machine, ZBook X2 is a mobile workstation hardware. This help you to give that in the road, he can do any work. So that kind of flexible hardware HP used to build. So when you're going to the portfolio session, I will speak about more about each hardware. So HP, we are coming with the most secure hardware solution. So that is called Remote Performance Centralized Workstation. So what all about that? So you might be having a 4 workstation or 5 workstation, but people will be used for various software. But you have a challenge in the managing your license and you're managing your end-to-end hardware solutions. HP gives a very, very simple and cost-effective solution when it comes to the design team. So you have whatever the machines which you have, so we can convert into the rack format and put it in the rack and using the software called the Central Broker. So this help you to pull your machines into the single system. So where if the team need to have, some person need to have a special CAD application, you can assign. And if that person, you don't want to use a CAD application, you want to switch it to the simulation application, so you can switch it that. So what's the advantage of this hardware? Your central you can manage, and your power can be managed. Your overall IT complex solution, like, you know, if you talk about any segment, if it is a large customer or the small, medium segment customers. So the, when it comes to the IT manageability, it's the biggest pain. So where this solution, which help you to collaborate as well as, you know, optimize your end-to-end solution. So during our, you know, biggest pain area, which I said, collaboration, real-time collaboration. So HP comes whenever you choose a hardware, there is a software called Remote Graphics Software. So this will come by default with the software. So this software have an advantage where you can take your machine remotely and you get the same performance of your workstation in your cell phone or your laptop or your desktop, any kind of form of hardware, you get the same performance. So let's talk about a real-time situation. The person sitting in Bangalore, the workstation is deployed and he creating a content and he wants to visualize this to his customer who's sitting in the Mumbai or outside India, anywhere you talk about situations. So, but you can't carry the workstation or the other situation. The data cannot be given to the other customer and look into that. So this kind of situation where you can take this machine remotely and you get the same power of workstation in the any form of the hardware. It could be a cell phone or it could be a iPhone or it could be a laptop or it could be a desktop. So you get the same seamless hardware experience in the other device. So this is an overall solution which help you to maximize your performance. So security is the biggest concern, right? So every machine will be deployed in the data center, or you can create your own rack, you can mount it, and you can manage that. So simplify the solution which you are offering to the workstation users. Security. So when you talk about, I'm talking about security in terms of soft, not on the physical. So when you choose your software, right, anybody can hack your machine. So in the hardware level, HP give a solution called HP SureStart. So recent days before, I think year before, ransom, there is a hardware level virus got attacked, and people need to pay some money to release the machine, right? So that is happened because of your hardware was hacked, not on the software side, your entire hardware, because of the system got locked by the hardware. So what will happen? So taking that is a pain area. So HP, we build a machine with SureStart. So your machine was hacked with your BIOS level. So HP give a solution on the BIOS level. If there is a malware that attacked, so when your antivirus in your machine, people will assume, okay, I have antivirus, how that hacker will hack. But your antivirus will start when your machine is powered on or when your Windows is boot up. But that is the pain. But if the machine is connected to the network, if you have internet in that machine, so anybody can remotely log in and you can take the machine. If they know your security code, your network security code, they will be able to log in and hack your machine. So to protect that, HP gives a solution called SureStart, which help you to protect in your BIOS level. If there is a malware attack, the system will automatically revamp and it will not allow you to boot the machine. So that helps you to do that. Coming to the SureClick, that is a very, very interesting software. So so how a virus will be come inside your machine? So most of the time when we download the software or when you download the content from your web, so if you go to unauthorized websites, so when you download a thing, so automatically the virus threat will be come inside your machine. So what HP is, we build a software called HP SureClick. So HP SureClick, it will be protect your browser. It could be a Internet Explorer or Google Chrome or Fox, any of the things actually when you install this software. So this software will help you to show your browser as a computer. Okay, the virus, the threat, so most of the time it will go inside based on that they know your machine, right? So that programmers, they will identify the how it will be in, go inside your machine, so identifying the root kernel and other things. Here, so the SureClick software, it will show to the browser as a computer to the virus threat. So what will happen when you browse something, when you download something, everything will be in the under SureClick sense only. So automatically when you close your browser, so automatically all the virus will be get terminated. It is a very, very simplified format that this software will be given with all our workstations. So when you choose your workstation, so it comes remote graphic software, which help you to remotely collaborate, where you can connect with the people and you get the experience and you can show your content. Second thing, SureStart, SureClick, similarly SureSense, okay. So from the day one, if your antivirus is not attacked, so the machine is learned with the no database of, you know, virus, so it will help you to protect your machine. So this all the software will come with that, you know. It is not like that when you're choosing a hardware only for the ISP certified, where DESO or PTC, which they certified hardware, plus you have a lot of protection as well as on the security side and the collaboration. We build a solution for the remote graphics software, and there are a couple of software which help you to improve your performance that I will come into the next coming slides on that. So this comes by default with your machine, okay. So I just want to quickly get into the product portfolio, so that will help you to know when you think about your application, so how you can choose your hardware. So we have a tower workstation, we have a mobile workstation, and we have a Z display. We have, when it comes to the workstation family, so we have a three range of products. So when you talk about tower workstation, we have from Z1 to Z8, okay. So what kind of hardware I need to choose, what kind of application, based on that only we need to choose the hardware, which I said, okay, I have a budget of 10 lakh rupees, let's go and choose the biggest machine. No, it is not like the case. So whenever through channel or if any customer reaching us, we ask first question when it comes to the workstation, like when you go and talk to the enterprise team, so they will ask first question, what is your application, what is your data set, what complex? So based on that only, we recommend a hardware. So when you go and talk about storage guys, they will ask you first question, how much incremental data you are going to get. So based on that only, they will size your storage, right? Similarly, workstation, we build based on your application and data set. So if you talk about Z1, Z2, and Z4, these are the machines which comes with the single processor. Okay, workstation largely comes with a single processor as well as the dual processor. So single process machines is the best machine for any of the application which used for design or creating a content. So if you talk about product development, so the application largely SolidWorks, PTC, Siemens NX or UG, Dassault, CATIA, Autodesk, AutoCAD, or these are the application. When it comes to media customers, Maya, 3DX Max, Adobe, Autodesk, so these are all the applications largely used on the media customers. If you talk about architects, Revit, so Navisworks, these are all the applications. So we'll largely use for developing a content, right? So this is the best machine you can Z1 to Z4. So Z1 to Z2, these two combination machines, which largely used for the entry level and mid-range data set. Suppose my data is more complex, I need to have a more powerful machine. Then think about Z4. If it is an entry or mid-range data set, you can think about Z1 or Z2. So when it comes to Z6 or Z8, these machines largely used for the applications for simulation. So CAE, CFD, rendering, or artificial intelligence, data science. So these are the area where if you are working, so you need to choose the hardware Z6 or Z8. So this helps you to improve your performance based on the hardware availability. Because of this hardware comes with the dual socket, and you get the maximum scalability in terms of memory, in terms of graphic power, in terms of GPU power, you can get it through there. So this is where the tower workstation falls under. Coming to the mobile workstation, very simplified format, 14, 15, and 17. So based on the screen size, we build our machines. So 14 and 15, it is a lightweight. So workstations in the mobile, so we classify into performance and premium. So premium, it is a more of people want lightweight. I don't want to carry a much weight product. So I need more power with a lesser weight. So that is called premium segment. When it comes to performance, so weight is a constraint, but it is not too heavy. It is all less than 2.5 kg, but where we can get a more power. So that's where we fall into. But we have a pre-qualified premium product that is called X2 Studio and Studio 360. So X2 is largely a detachable workstation, which I said, you know, it is a form of, it is an innovation product from the HP workstation family. So where you can, it work like a tablet, right? You know, where you can use like a tablet, which comes with the Wacom touch pen. So where you can create your content. And if you want to use with the keyboard attached, you can use your traditional workstation. Studio is a product, comes with the 1.8 kg weight product. And Studio 360, it is a completely convertible workstation with the 4K resolution support displays. So and 15 and 17 is a full-blown of mobile workstation. We are ready hardware. So this is where our mobile workstation portfolio falls. Coming to the Z display, so tower and mobile, okay. So when it comes to the professional, the color is very, very important. The accuracy level is very, very important when people want to visualize. So HP, we build a Z display. So on the curved display and the virtual reality side and the 4K, 5K displays and narrow bezel. So narrow bezel is a very thin bezel. From 22 inch to 27 inch, we build the machine. So all the form factor which we have a special device called Dream Color. Okay, if the people who work on the color space, something where they want to want to calibrate the color and they want to measure their specific color tone or they want to maintain a specific color tone. So all the panels which is available, if you talk about professional displays or pre-calibrated, it comes with the pre-calibrated format. Where the Dream Color is a device which you can calibrate and we can, as per the color tone, we can set. So this is very, very unique to HP product. So this Dream Color technology, which is actually generation 2 now, which gives a more color space, more color accuracy, we built in this machine. So people interested very specific and the color, many of the time people are not even aware of this technology. So the color calibration, most of the time it will be calibrated from the factory, where this device is possible to calibrate from our side. Coming to the VR, okay, so VR as a technology, you know, it is coming in very, very high level. So HP, if I talk about HP, gives end-to-end solution on the VR side. Not only on the hardware, we are giving a solution on the software. HP Unity, we are a very big partnership across the globe. As in India, we are very, very strong. Recently, we had a joint partnership with when the Unity conduct the VR world in the Kochi. HP was the official partner. We given the complete solution. So we build hardware along with the Unity software. If somebody want to create a content and experience the content, so HP give the both solution. So largely workstations are deployed for creating a content, right? But when it comes to the experience, you have a challenge with the boundaries and the data set, how you can experience the VR, immersive VR experience. So you have some bottlenecks. Keeping all the bottlenecks, we removed and we are building the device called HP ZVR Backpack. So this ZVR Backpack, it is comes form of the backpack format where the person can wear the device and he can move around. So he can experience the content, immersive content in the largest scale. So that gives us, you know, biggest thing. So people who are, if your people are joined from webinar from Delhi, so we have a customer welcome center in the Connaught Place. So maybe we request you to walk into our CWC, customer welcome center in Connaught Place. Maybe you can experience this, you know, experience on the virtual reality world. So how you can collaborate and you can showcase. So VR as a technology, it helps you to reduce your cost on the many factors. Okay. When you want to build a prototype device or when you want to test something on real time. So these are all the things due to safety and the cost constraint. So this technology helps you to do a multiple time with a less effort. And if you talk about real-time situation, if I want to do a crash test, so or if you're going to do a training and simulation, so you have a challenge when it comes to the real-time. But where this VR and technology is still helping you to do that. So just to want to give you some examples like, you know, automotive space, if you want to do a training, you want to remove the complete component and you want to do that, so you need to spend money for that, you know, creating a prototype. Instead of that, you can create a soft content through VR. In the healthcare industry, people with real-time situation, they can't do that, you know, multiple time surgery. Where this technology help you to practice surgeon to multiple times. So that is actually a biggest technology it's revolving in the healthcare industry. So HP gives complete support on the hardware as well as software front. Another important area, people who work on the data science, the machine learning or deep learning concept. So most of the time, if you talk about in the Asia Pacific, there was a survey was speaking, 250,000 data scientists required to consult for the data science requirement. But the challenge is, if you talk about that much data scientists, you don't have that much space in the cloud because of reason behind how much data can run it in the cloud and your internet cost, and every time you need to spend money on the using your cloud. So these are the biggest thing, pain and the cost, as well as, you know, using your technology with the limited space. Where workstations are very, very important element when it comes to the machine learning. The machine learning algorithms runs only on the GPU compute. GPU compute is nothing but your graphic card, which enabled with the CUDA and tensor cores. So workstations are largely built with the highest GPU cards, NVIDIA Coro, GV100, GP100, or RTX 6000 or 8000. So you can mount multiple GPU cards in that machine, and you can manage all your data in your disk size. So you are able to easily manage your end-to-end hardware in front of you. So when it comes to VR and when it comes to the machine learning, see, the both segment, people actually strongly choosing the hardware, and we are seeing the lot of gap on the investment. So very specifically, we want to highlight, so HP giving a extreme hardware and software solution for the machine learning as well as the VR. So if anybody interested, please reach out. We will be able to give you the right guidance and the right solution on this front. Okay, so I was talking about tower, it was talking about mobile workstation and the Z display cloud against the workstation and the VR solutions. So all this is all more of hardware side. So how do I choose right hardware against my application, or I have a hardware, but am I using my hardware effectively with my application? So how do I measure that? So this is all the pain area when it comes to that, you know, the IT building a team. So they will be consultant, they deploy some third-party tool, and they will give a report, and they will analyze and give a summary, then they will fine-tune that. So you don't need to run pillar to post to do this activity. Very simple solution. Any workstation, HP, it comes with the software called HP Performance Advisor. So this software, which help you to fine-tune your hardware. Suppose I'm running a SolidWorks 2016 with ANSYS 17 version, but my application, I don't know how much hardware is utilized and what is the bottleneck to, or what is how to improve my performance. These are my questions. So most of the time, consultants give the very overall view, but it may be a lead to that investment. But this software will help you to exactly show where is the bottleneck and how to improve. The software which have intelligence will help you to recommend on the software side what all the fine-tuning you need to do that. And with this fine-tuning, you will be able to see improvement. HP give minimum guarantee of 30%. He can show you the improvement up to 70%. So this software will help you to do two things. One is fine-tune your hardware. Second thing, your future investment, where I need to spend money. Suppose I have an application, I have a hardware, but is this the right one? So this software will help you to exactly show you, and it will give the end-to-end graphic view. So there is a YouTube video is available, or reach out. We will be able to support you to fine-tune from the software. If you are using a Z workstation, simply, you can just search HP Performance Advisor software, download the software, install it, and let us know if you are able to get any challenge, if we will be able to support you that. Right. So this is the software which I spoke, remote graphic software, which we are integrating into centralized solution. So this is the software which I was talking. So maybe I'll just give you the picture, will help you to explain much better. So there's a gentleman sitting in the left with the workstation with the bigger machines. Right side, there are four people connecting with the same machines. One guy using a desktop, one guy using a tablet, one guy using a laptop, another using another desktop. Four guys using the same data at the same time, and they get the same performance on the remotely. So this software will help you to collaborate. This is not a sharing. I just want to, sometimes people are misunderstanding. This is not actually a sharing. This is a collaboration software. So how we are connecting through webinar and we are watching. So I'm giving a presentation, somebody's listening. If somebody wants to ask question, so I need to go for a mute, then somebody needs to unmute. And so this is this kind of collaboration. So you can do this through this software. So most of the time, this software will work. Maybe looks like your remote desktop or any desk kind of software. But this will help, works only on your normal environment. When it comes to the design environment, CAD application, so you need to have a similar hardware on the other side, where this software help you to seamlessly same experience in the any device. It could be a notebook, it could be a cell phone, or it could be a tablet. You get the same experience. So this is called remote graphics software. Okay, so let's come to the time. So let's very simplify the solution. HP, I give. Talk about hardware, I talk about the pain area. So maybe based on my workflow or based on my application, so how do I choose my device? So very simple, just go to Google, type Z by HP, or go to HP.com, you can find the Z workstation. You can find the similar screen. So you have two options, by work nature or by software. So I taken a sample of by choosing an industry, by software. So what kind of industry I am from? Let's talk about architect or creative pro or media entertainment or product development or for the education. So what kind of content? So every vertical there is a software is integrated, right? So when I choose that, so I choose a media and entertainment applications. So there is a list of software, maybe it's maybe very small. So when you log into the HP portal, you get a better view. So you get the list of software. Similarly, you go, so when you choose the application, so it recommends good, best, better configuration, right? And also it will help you to choose configuration and everything you can simplify the tool we given in that. So ZBike HP, you can search in the Google or go to HP.com. Go to workstation page, so you'll able to get the screen. So you will able to select the right hardware. So just in the summary, this is my last slide. In the overall summary, so keeping the pain, so HP builds a lot of solution on the hardware side. So when it comes to the collaboration, when it comes to the performance fine tuning, when it comes to the security, when it comes to the reliable thing, so we build a machine based on the pain and customer or the workstation users pain, we convert into the productivity. So using a Z workstation. So that's it from my side. So let's take for, I'm sure it will be 4 o'clock session get over, but I will take maximum question and I can address. I can see a lot of chat questions. Somebody can, okay, I can read the question and I can address. If any phone question comes up also, I can start and explain.
With that said, ladies and gentlemen, I would like to request if you wish to ask any questions, please put your queries in the chat appearing on the right side of the WebEx screen. For the participants who have joined in through the audio, would request you to please press 0 and 1 on your telephone keypad. Repeating and requesting again, ladies and gentlemen, if you wish to ask any questions, please press 0 and 1 on your telephone keypad. Participants joining in on the WebEx, please post your queries on the chat appearing on the right side of the window.
Okay, Rudy, there is a couple of questions. Let me answer the question. There is a question from Mr. Neeraj Sinha. Is there any possibility of demo of given product by HP? Yes, very good. So yes, we have a demo device very much available. So Neeraj, I'm not sure from which region. So maybe you can reach out, send out a mail to the Unstoppable team. There is an email ID. Reach out from your respective location. And we have a partners aligned with every region, and every partner will be filled with demo devices. If there is specific requirement, we build. That is a one advantage. Okay, you're from Pune, good. So maybe I can connect with respective partner, send out an email. So we will able to arrange a demo device. And HP, we have a very specific, depends on the volume of size. We build exclusive size of the same hardware we built and give for demo. So that is a question for you. And the second question, HP security, browsing security. Okay, so we don't have industrial PC. So more of, so the question is more of industrial PC used on the shop floor, but workstations can be used on the shop floors, okay? Because of we build a machine with design for environment. So design for environment means depends on the location, depends on the environment. There will be additional hardware will be integrated. Let's talk about, give you an example. If you talk about in India, in the month of July to September, there will be a monsoon period. It will start from the Kerala and it goes up to Mumbai. My entire region, coastal area will be hit. So those time, your hardware period will be increased. So I remember, almost 10 years before we taken as a project, we built a solution exclusively for the design for environment under project. We integrated a couple of components inside the machine to protect the failure during the monsoon time. So for your question, for a shop floor, so we have, if you talk about most of the OEMs, automotive OEMs, the workstations are used with the CNC machines, a couple of industrial machines. So where machines are connected and it used in the 365 days, we add a component called dust filter, simple technology, which helps you to protect your machine from the environmental failure. So you can use, but we don't have an industrial PC, but we have a device for exclusive for the shop floors kind of things. So that is the thing. I just want to give you an answer. Maybe hope it will help you. We are using a Z series engineering team with memory is 100. The performance is not up to the mark. We are expecting many times the system stack, no response. Wow. So this is from, okay, this question again from Neeraj from Pune. Okay, so if I talk about, I spoke about, there is an application called HP Performance Advisor. I would request you to download the software, install that, and it will help you to exactly tell what is the reason for your machine is slow. Okay, so if you have a machine with a 128 GB memory, so if you talk about Katia, it technically it use 128 GB. So if your data is demand, it will take, otherwise it will not take. It is a depends on the application behavior. If you talk about SolidWorks as an application, it never take more than 64 GB memory. So that is a bottleneck, or that is the challenge in the application behavior. So every application which have their own limitations. So what we can do, we can analyze exactly why your machine is slow, why it is stuck. The software will give you the exact figure. And the software also recommend why your machine is slow, what you're supposed to do there. If there is a challenge, please reach out. We will able to help you to send an aligned engineer. We will able to support you at that point. And another question.
So there is a question yeah. From Mr. Abhijit K. The question reads out as, with which X factor, how many times Z15 or Z Studio desktops are expensive than normal desktops?
Can you repeat again? It is a more of commercial question. So the question is, my understanding is, just correct me.
With which X factors, how many times Z15 or Z Studio desktops are expensive than the normal desktops?
Yeah. Okay. So it is expensive, but I can't quantify that how much X. But when you choose workstation against the normal desktop, what are the advantage? When you choose a workstation, first very, very important element, it is from the ISV certified hardware. Workstation means it's ISV certified. HP also have a desktop, HP also have a laptop, but that is, we call it as a desktop or laptop only. We never call it as a high-end desktop or high-end notebook, no. We call it as a desktop, laptop, workstation only. The difference is the hardware never ever given to any of the ISV and they never touch. So, and the second thing, workstations largely supported by the pre-sale, post-sale, there is a consultant available, there is a dedicated team we support for this, like how you choose a server. Similarly, workstation, we build with a very dedicated team we work. My day starts with workstation, ends with workstation. 25 years, I'm in the same business, I'm with the, working with a different customer application. So we will be able to do a real-time consulting for that. But when it comes to desktop, it's a more of hardware business, apple-to-apple comparison, processor, RAM, hard drive, those things. So, workstations used by the professionals, but not desktops, right? So, it is not a cost. So, when it comes to any of the engineering company, workstation falls under the IT budget also. They never include workstation. This part of the R&D budget only. So, always it's expensive, but it gives a better experience. And your performance, if you compare, you get almost 10 times better performance when you compare with your desktop against your workstation. So that's what I can say that.
So there is another question from Mr. Rajesh Bamnia. The question reads out as, how can we get the demo? Will it be on cloud or physical devices?
Physical devices. Workstations are physical devices. And someone was asking about the cloud against workstation. How we can get demo in cloud? Okay, this is the one. This is actually a physical device. We will not give, there is no way of cloud. We give a machine, real-time machine. It could be a tower, or it could be a mobile. Based on the hardware, we will be able to provide the demo devices.
Thank you so much. The next question is coming up from Mr. Manish Gupta. The question reads out as, what factors will decide the usage between the workstation and desktop?
Okay, so, workstation, it is made for development. Desktop is already developed. Like example, simple, like, you know, when I was explaining about consumer graphic card, professional graphic card. If layman language, if I explain, to play game, consumer graphic card. To create a game, professional graphic card. Similarly, so if your applications, like, you know, your day-to-day transaction application, like MS Office, Word, browsing, or your some of the basic financial application, can be run it on the desktop. But when it comes to the workstation, it is largely used for applications for create a content, for create a simulation. So those kind of situations. Okay, so if you talk about HPC, there is a very, very high level word, high performance computing. So largely when you have a, when you want to run a simulation, I need to have a 100 core CPU or I need to have a 250 GB memory. This is all history now. So I'm able to give everything in one workstation. You don't need to have a 100 machines, you have one machine. Simple formula, we have a Z8 workstation. If I want to give the output of the Z8 machine, it is equal to the 18 server populated with each server with 8 core CPU. So what is the output I'm able to drive? Same output I can drive from the Z8 with the GPU compute. So just imagine 18 servers with one machine. So that much power we can drive. So this is a depends on the application where the workstation falls under that.
Thank you so much. There are no further questions at this point of time. Turning the program back to you for a closing statement.
Thank you so much, Rudy, Thomas. Thank you so much. Hope it will be useful session, I'm sure. Please reach out for the program team and send out an email. So I will connect to the respective location people and I'll ask the respective channel partner to reach out and support and respond. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thanks, this is Thomas here. Thanks and signing off. Thanks, Senthil, for a truly immersive workstation, a set of solution showcasing to us. Thanks, Rudy, for your, and thank you so much for the audience and all the delegates who have attended this, for your questions as well.
All the participants, respected speakers, Mr. George and Mr. Senthil, for joining. Thank you so much for joining the call and for the wonderful presentation. Wish you all have a blessed day ahead. Thank you so much.
Thank you.